Everybody, welcome to episode 14 of Two Bitches on a Bench. We are back outside this season. I can never get this right. Which river is this?
Elbow.
We are recording from the banks of the Elbow River, which is flowing swiftly. And it's a beautiful, sunny, bright spring day today. Nice and warm. Moments of coolness. Today we are going to talk about our struggles with
weight.
Our struggles with weight?
No, well, I was going to say, my name is Dish Number Two, and I am an overeater, an emotional eater. So, you kind of took the wind out of my sails.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, well, to follow in your footsteps, to ride your coattails, I am Bitch Number One, and I am a boredom eater.
Boredom eater?
Yep. And, okay, so you go with that. Lead us in. Take a scenario of what that looks like.
Well, everything's good. I'm happy. I'm excited. I'm whatever like that. And I eat when I need to, and I generally make good food decisions.
Which... That's pretty rare.
The other extreme of the spectrum is I'm going through a really hard time, I feel awful, something traumatic has happened, and I don't eat at all. Which also is not overly common. It's this mid part of things are okay, I'm not satisfied, I'm not pleased. Everything's just kind of bleh, bleh, and that's when I need to fill myself up with oodles and oodles of noodles and other delicacies. It's not usually noodles, but
other,
I was going for alliteration.
Other delicacies would also insinuate that noodles are a delicacy.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I guess it's good that you recognize that.
Oh, no, I know that. I know that for sure. What to do with it, I'm not sure. Because part of it, too, is there is... I know what to do. I know what to eat. I know how I should be eating in order to feel better. But I choose not to. And it's not because... I mean, I find eating good, healthy, clean, whole foods is easy. It's really not that difficult.
No.
I can find really, really easy recipes, too, but I choose not to. And why? Why, I ask you, why?
You do understand I could break into song here.
I know. Let's go.
Okay. So can I tell you my story?
Yeah.
This doesn't relate to being a boredom eater, because I eat when I'm at work, and it's not that I'm bored, it's more, I'm not fulfilled,
yeah.
Maybe?
Well, that's like me, too.
Challenged, maybe?
Sure.
Yeah, and it's...
Things are just not the way you want them.
Right.
In whatever capacity.
Exactly. So then I'll go home, and I love my home. I have a very inspiring home, I think. It needs a little bit of interior decorating, but it's a beautiful home. And I'll get home and I'm tired. I'm tired from being...
unfulfilled?
Yes. So then I nap. I could be doing creative stuff, but I choose to nap. And then when I get up from my nap, I think, okay, well... In my mind, I want to be done eating by latest 7 o'clock.
Which is good.
Yeah. But then I'll just go for something quick. And that's probably the bag of chips and the licorice. Or maybe I don't eat at all. Or maybe it's chocolate bar. But anyway.
We'll see.
Yeah. So we both had done Whole 30.
30 days.
And
Rule 30 is 30 days, no sugar of any type, no sweetener, so no stevia, honey, anything like that, agave, no grains, obviously, no legumes, bye-bye peanut butter, and no alcohol.
Right.
For 30 days.
Yeah. And no things like things that I would turn to as a filler would be crackers, bagel, stuff like that. And there was none of that.
Well, those are great.
Right.
But the other part of it is no making comfort food with Whole30 ingredients. So you're not supposed to have like paleo pancakes, which is perfectly Whole30. You're not supposed to have that because you're trying to break that whole reliance on I need something to comfort me, which is food.
Yeah.
Anyway, go on.
So we did that, and then I did pretty good considering my eating habits. I still caved and had the occasional coffee with cream and sugar in it. A latte, right?
Latte's not cream and sugar. Latte's just milk and espresso.
Okay, well, it's still milk.
Well, yeah, but still, I would give you almond milk.
Okay, but sometimes, like, on my birthday, as an example, I went to get my free Starbucks coffee, and that is what I had.
The truth comes out, people.
I'm pretty sure I told you that.
I don't think so.
I did. So, you know, there was those occasional oops, although it wasn't an oops because it was an intentional thing. But overall, I did pretty good. And I didn't realize at the time how much better I felt now that I can compare back. But I was looking for different results also. Anyway, went to LA, went to my favorite candy store, bought a bag of candy, gorged on candy, and on the same day...
And cupcake.
Wait, I haven't got there yet.
Okay, sorry.
And then went to Sprinkles, instant teller machine for cupcakes.
ATM,
sorry. And got a cupcake, and it was delicious. It was so good. And that night, I was sick to my stomach. Sick from all of the shit that I had put in my body. However, if you asked me today, do you want to go to the candy store? I would run there. And I'm sore from a workout that I haven't done for a really long time, but I would meet you there.
She would run.
I would push you on the road in front of traffic to get to the candy store. So,
you know where I stand.
You wouldn't. You'd be laying on the road because I pushed you. My thing is... Okay, sorry, before I say that. You told me that you were going to start Whole30 last week, right? That was your intention?
That was my intention.
Right. Oh, look at how fast the ducky's going. Excuse me for the interlude. But you didn't, right?
No.
Okay, so what held you back?
Preparedness. I'm not sure. I don't have a good excuse. I really don't. I don't have a good explanation, rationale, anything like that. I really don't. With the exception of preparedness. I had fully intended, like, I bought stuff. I ended up... Like, I got some chicken and some turkey, and I ended up freezing it, which is good, so I'll have it. Part of it is, though, months ago, I had a food subscription box.
Yep.
And I thought that I had done what I needed to cancel it, but it turns out I didn't. And I got an email that said, hey, your box is on the way on Monday, which is fine. So, no, I haven't been eating Whole30 this week. I've been doing a little bit better than normal because I had this box that came. So I had, there's actually this really good salad. It was arugula, some like, you know, not fried, but like ground up some peppers, some bell peppers.
Mm-hmm.
There was a sun-dried tomato pesto, olives, feta, and then this really interesting type of pasta. Like, it was like a fresh pasta. It was weird, and you still had to put it in water, but it was soft. And I'm not, like, it might be a whole wheat kind of pasta or something. But anyway, so that was really good. Like, that tasted really good this week. I also made, there were pizzas, like little, just two individual pizzas in the box, and I had that. And then there's a vegetarian paella, which I haven't made yet. It's all still in the fridge, so that was part of the reason too. So
I did
freeze my stuff,
yeah.
But I made sure to go forward, not have that. But no, there isn't an excuse.
Okay, because I had intended on, there was a plan we had done a few years ago that worked quite well for me. And you ate the same thing every day for breakfast, and the same thing every day for lunch, and the same thing every day for dinner.
Sounds great.
It was very easy to grocery shop.
Mm.
It was food that I liked, though. Like, so
plain.
Yeah. I had fully intended on starting that on Tuesday last week after the long weekend. Do it for 10 days, which would take us to the end of May. And then I was going to start Whole30 June 1st.
June 1st is next Friday.
I know.
Okay.
But I didn't do the 10-day thing. Like, I bought the stuff for it, and I did not do it. And to be honest with you, if you ask me right now what I had for lunch last week, other than the day that I went out for lunch, I couldn't tell you. I don't remember, really. I think I had peanut butter and honey on buns one day.
Mmm!
That was good. Anyway, the point being, I relate it to the same thing as the boredom eating. And I can't get my headspace around it to be able to focus on Whole30. And that's kind of what's bothering me, is because, you know, when I get focused on something, I get pretty OCD about it.
Yeah.
And I can't get there with this, and I don't know why. I know it would be good for me.
And you know how you felt on Whole30.
Mm-hmm.
Because I would say for me too, even the weeks that I wasn't feeling super great, like I was just kind of run down and I think my body was just adjusting to the new diet, even when I didn't feel great, I still felt 100 times better than
yep.
I do right at this very moment in time.
Yep.
And all I've done is fill my body with junk or comfort food.
Yeah. So, I guess, are you starting Whole30 then?
Well, I want to. I was thinking I might just start it for June 1st.
See, that's what I was going to do, and then run it for the 30 days of June. I think for me, though, I probably need to do it consistently for
3 months.
Me too. At least. Because my sugar habit... And every time I try to stop it and I think that I'm okay and then I have something and it triggers it again, it's this gargantuan monster that's 12 times bigger than it was before I stopped. And I don't know what to do about that.
Or is that just your perception?
No, it's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. Like, there's a... call it a dessert, really. Rice Krispies, corn flakes, corn syrup, butter.
Butterscotch chips, chocolate chips.
Yeah. I didn't have butterscotch chips, but I did have the rest of it, and vanilla.
We call it hunk.
Yes.
And why do we call it hunk?
Because way back when I was trying to kick a sugar habit, I would make that.
We're talking like 15 years ago.
Yeah. I would make it, and instead of putting it in a pan and slicing it like you're supposed to, or dropping it in little blobs to make little kind of cookie things, I just froze the whole thing as it came out of the pot in the freezer, in a bag, and then take it out and gnaw on it.
Yeah. What, after she had just done the treadmill, walked on the treadmill, and burned 1,000 calories. So,
okay, so see,
so
there,
in the dark basement, in your little corner by the deep freeze, unhung.
Well, here's the stupid thing about that. So talking about the getting OCD about stuff.
The treadmill.
I was faithful with the treadmill at least 6 days a week. I would not get off of the treadmill until I had burned 1,000 calories, however long that took me. And I was faithful at it. Every single day, I was on that thing.
Okay, but you're also like that about your steps, too, now, though.
Yes. So why can't I be like that about food?
I don't know.
And then, okay, so anyways, our hunk. I made a few of those since being off Whole 30.
You've made a few?
Uh-huh. And eaten them all.
So, interesting.
So yes, I am worse again. Because at least before when I'd make that thing, it would last a week, 2 days, maybe. Day and a half, sometimes. Day and a half. The whole thing. I ate it.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't... I know that, like, you could go to a dietitian or a nutritionist or whatever. And, you know, I'd have to report back. But that can't go on forever. And the thing with me is, as soon as that period of time is done, when I don't have to be accountable to somebody for my food journal or whatever it is, I'm back at it. Killing.
Yeah, but you also haven't gone long enough. You have not gone consistently more than a month without sugary stuff.
The longest I've probably gone... That would have been Melissa Davis. So when I go to her twice a week, I'd have to show her my food journal. It's pretty good.
But for how long, though?
Well, I think I went to her for... I don't know. I don't think I went to her for a year. 6 months, maybe?
No.
4 months? 3 months? I don't really... I can't remember how long I went, but for whatever that period of time was... I stayed off the sugar, but I also was going to her
Tuesday
and Thursday.
Yeah, but you also didn't really stay off the sugar, because you think about the recipes that she gave. Really, the recipes were about keeping under, let's say, a 1,200 calorie day.
Yeah, that's true.
So, yeah, that's all fine and great. You're still allowed to have muffins that have honey or
right.
maple syrup in it, and you're allowed to have flour, and you're allowed to have... tomato sauces, and you're allowed to have dressings, and you're
right,
which there's still gonna be sugar in that.
Yeah, that's true. You're
and
yeah.
Like I think about we were allowed to eat cashew bars.
Mm-hmm. And those are full of sugar.
Probably, yeah, I would think.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what to do, but I know that all of my years of eating that way is starting to catch up with me.
Mm-hmm.
And I need to fix it before it's too late and I can't fix it.
Well, I want to fix it too.
And I, like you, I know how, but I can't get my brain to do it for some stupid reason.
Yeah, I know, me too.
So I guess there's no point in me saying to you what should we do.
Well, I mean, unless the answer is just as simple as we do it.
Okay, but I don't know if you're as bad as I am.
I have my moments. Once I get into it, I'll be able to get into it. But yeah, you just kind of have to.
I guess. I think a lot of it, too, is finding a way to fill that boredom. Unfulfillment? Not boredom. Because I'm not necessarily bored.
I am. TV and food. My
couch and junk.
And TV for you too. When I said to you that I wanted to cancel Netflix, you were like, no! What about all the shows?
It's not that I sit and watch it, I pace.
You I pace and watch TV. Instead of just going outside and taking a walk around your neighborhood, you pace.
Yes.
In your, what, 900 square foot main floor?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, okay. So this makes me think of something else that I came across this week, and I had told you about it. And you said, oh, that's cool, but you answered too fast, so I knew that you didn't actually look at it. It was on, as you hate it that I say, Pinterest.
Mm-hmm.
And it was bullet journaling.
I did look at it.
That was a really quick look, because I barely sent the message and replied back and said, oh, that's neat. Anyway, I'm kind of wondering if maybe that might be something that would work. A, it's fine. My kind of fine. Because it's writing and stationery and all that fun stuff. And it's being creative with fonts and tabs and labels and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But there was one that I came across that was about food and fitness. And I thought that I might give it a try just to see if my weirdness with, you know, journaling and colored pencils and all of that kind of stuff would help me, motivate me to be able to do my journal by the proper foods and exercise.
Okay.
Any comments about that? Because you know what I'm like.
Yeah, I do. I guess my whole thing is how many times have you bought stuff like that? And what's going to be the difference making it stick? You know?
Well, this particular one, you don't buy a journal.
No, I know. I know.
And
but
you know I like to play with pens and pencils.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I thought that maybe.
Well, I mean, I suppose it's worth a try. My question just is, what is it that makes this different from any other time?
I was hoping that bringing the creativity side of it into it might be my way to make the connection between the two.
Right.
Because I tend to be able to stick to something a bit longer if it's creative than if it feels like or if I have to. And I know I don't have to. It's me telling myself that I need to. But in my head, I still feel like that little kid that, you know, digging my heels in and nobody's looking.
But it's because you said that you need to.
Yeah.
You should want to.
I know. And I do. I do want to.
But then there's that obligation part of it where, I don't know. I really don't know.
It's almost like the little kid part of me comes out and I'm rebelling.
Yeah.
It's like the adult is telling me that I have to do this. Oh, but wait, the adult isn't looking. So the little kid comes out and he's like, nobody's gonna know, so I'm gonna eat a whole thing of hunk in a day and a half that should actually last a week. So I'll make another one so that nobody knows me that I ate it, even though nobody knew I had it in the first place.
Yeah, I didn't know. That's a surprise. She lied to me for over a month about going to get her birthday drink at Starbucks. I'm appalled.
I didn't lie.
You lied.
I didn't lie. I just never said anything.
I thought you said that you said something.
I told you another time that I had coffee that I got a coffee from Starbucks. Because I met somebody. It was a work thing. And I met somebody for coffee. Because remember I
said
you...
Yeah, you asked me what to order and I told you. But apparently you didn't.
No. That time was on my way to work to get a coffee.
No. You did ask.
But didn't I know? That's what I'm saying. I asked you because I was going to work and I wanted to get a coffee.
No, you asked me. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. She's not right. She's being a bitch. Number two. Okay, so
How long have we blathered on for?
We blathered on for 25 minutes.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it. If anybody out there has done Whole 30, struggled, anybody...
I don't even know that we struggled, though.
Well, no, it wasn't really a struggle. It was...
I said to you that I was worried about coming off of Whole 30, and
yeah.
You said you were too.
Yeah.
Going back into that real world and being allowed to kind of eat whatever.
Yeah.
And this is my fear. This was my fear that this was going to happen.
Yeah.
And now I've completely gone off the rails again.
Me too. I think I sick to my stomach and that didn't even turn me off. Like, how could that
I threw,
that?
Okay, so we were in the hotel because we traveled, and when this one was puking, she said to me, get rid of everything, get rid of all the candy. So I threw the candy out in the garbage, and the next day we were packing stuff up, and she said, where's the candy? And I said, oh, I threw it out last night when you were sick. And she looked at me and she's like, well, are you sure we should have thrown it out? Do you want to pack it? I'm like, no. It's in the garbage.
I will admit, briefly, the thought crossed my mind to get it out of the garbage. It was still in the bag. Like, it's not
it was,
like it was
yeah,
mixed
and it wasn't a
garbage.
Dirty, it's not a dirty garbage. Like, it's just
but
a little...
Then I thought, no, I can't. I have to tell myself it's in the garbage. It has to stay in the garbage. But then, at the airport, What did we get at the airport to eat? There was the coffee.
Chex Mix?
Was it the Chex Mix? No, because that was the cheese one, so it wasn't sweet. We got something sweet. Because I asked you to get me something.
Oh, I can't remember.
I can't remember either. And then, okay, well, because I'm going to spend my month again. So, Monday was a holiday here, and I went across the street to Safeway, which is quite near my house, and that's not a good thing to have home. Unless I stay in pajamas and don't wash my hair for 6 days, then I won't go out, but... I went to Safeway and I bought Cool Whip and I bought that to put on berries. So that wasn't so bad, but not the best. And then I bought a croissant that was filled with real whipping cream and strawberries.
Like a cream puff.
Yes, like a cream puff.
Yeah, sorry, I'm just new here. So if it says two-hour parking Monday to Friday, we can still park there today, right? Two-hour parking Monday to Friday, that means you can park anytime today?
Sorry about that. There was a brief interruption. Okay, so I went to Safeway. I bought a croissant that was filled with real whipping cream, though, and strawberries, and then had chocolate drizzled on the top. Because it was only $1.79.
Only.
And then I bought...
On Tuesdays, they have big giant Texas donuts for $2.
At Safeway?
Yeah.
Why would you tell me that? Oh, but wait. Glamorgan Bakery, they're cheaper. They're only $1.75
okay.
every day.
Anyway.
And they're probably bigger than Safeway's. Anyway. Bought a bag of chips. A lightly salted Ripple. And I bought a bag of Cheetos. They're the jalapeno cheese flavor. I haven't eaten them all, though. It's Saturday, and they've been in the cupboard since Monday. I haven't eaten them all. And then I bought a 4-pack of Jersey Milk chocolate ice, and I don't have any left.
Say that again?
Bought a 4-pack, 4 chocolate bars, full-size Jersey Milk, and I don't have any left.
Interesting.
So, I am a severe sugar junkie. I have a severe problem. And I need help. Severe help. Very big help. Because I have also noticed a change in my bodily features.
Features, not functions, people.
Yeah. Features. And I don't like it. And
well, and this is the thing. You have been blessed. You're very lucky. For those of you who don't know what bitch number one looks like, she is a nitty bitty little thing, and she's pocket sized, and she's very, very lucky that, because the way she eats, for, let's say, a normal person, if I were to eat the way that you eat, I would be a porker.
Yeah, in
more so than I am now.
You're not a porker.
But
in theory, based on the way I eat, I acknowledge I should probably weigh 200 pounds or more.
Which wouldn't be possible on your frame, but if most people were to eat the way that you eat, which they probably do, like, especially if you're looking at American, like, that sort of American...
Lifestyle,
yeah. Diet.
Fast food.
Fast food, junk food.
Yeah.
A quick sugar fix, a quick energy. yeah. So, you have been very, very lucky in that you have been able to stave this off for so long.
However,
and that you come from a family of little skinny people, but yeah, you can say the rest. I was going somewhere, and now I can't remember where I was going.
Okay, well, I'll say the rest then on what I think. I think that now that I am the age that I am, that we're not going to say.
It can change.
time is catching up with me, and my body is not the same as it used to be, and it's harder and harder and harder for me to be happy with
what's
going on physiologically.
Well, it's interesting because you were just saying that 30 years ago, back when you were with child, me, what did you, only gained like 23 pounds?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I was 5.5 pounds of that.
Yeah.
Placenta was 1 to 2 pounds of that. All the goo was another couple pounds.
Yep.
So that right there too, like, I mean, so you are a tiny person and you just hide it. You hide it very well, but I have a feeling you are what they call, what is it, skinny fat?
Skinny fat, yeah.
Where you are skinny on the outside, but your insides, like, I joke that your insides are made of rock crystal candy. But
it's probably not much of a joke. Literally, if we could see inside there. Actually, I wish I could. I wish there was a way to see what was going on in there. And not an x-ray or basic stuff like that. I'd actually like to see
an endoscope.
As something of exactly what was going on in there. Because maybe that's what I need, is to be scared out of my mind. Like, We're prone to, or susceptible to, what's that word called that it transfers down from generations?
Hereditary.
Thank you. There are many things that we could possibly have go wrong. And for me, now is the time that I really need to pay attention. For you, you still have time to correct.
I need to
fix in a hurry. And sadly...
But it's not going to be easy, and it's not going to be overnight, is the thing. You stay in a hurry, but it's... You think about the amount of damage that you've done.
I know.
Right? From
yeah.
what you've been eating. Even from when you were a kid.
Yep.
Where Hamburger Helper and Beep and Alphabets and Sunny Delight and Lunchables and all of those things that... Well, I was talking about you and I.
Oh.
So. Or you think about, we were talking about this last week or the week before, but when I was a kid and you would pack lunch, and the same way that you would pack an apple in a kid's lunch, things like Gushers or Soda Delicious,
mm-hmm.
those were candy.
Yeah.
And those went into the lunch every single day.
Yeah. Because that was supposed to be the treat in the lunch, but also I didn't think it was that bad because I got lured in by the real fruit juice on the box, right? So, oh, well, these are sweet and it's a treat and oh they're not that bad because it says real fruit.
Well, yeah, and that's not a fault of yours at all.
No, but you're right, like all of that kind of stuff. And
the other thing too is how when we were doing Whole30 and there were a few times that I went out with some friends and how incredibly hard it is to eat.
Yeah.
On something like Whole30. That's a problem. That and you know, like being at work and people mean well, but they're just like, when are you gonna be off this crazy diet? And I'm like, well, you put that in my mind and I'm like, yeah, when am I gonna be off this? I want all the things. So it's just, I don't know.
Well, there was, I think probably in the last podcast I had said that my current office that I'm at, a lot of people bring in treats, muffins, cookies, and like once a month, the cleaning company brings in 2 boxes of donuts and 2 boxes of muffins. And then sometimes our boss, he'll go to Tim Hortons in the morning and he'll bring in, you know, 100 Timbits.
Aww.
Yeah. And then some people will make stuff and bring it in. But there's one person who works in the office. And the funny thing is that she's trying to lose weight. But that whole time that I was on Whole30 and there was stuff in the kitchen, she would come to my office and say, oh, don't let the sugar in the kitchen lure you in. Oh, did you know there's cookies in the kitchen? Oh, did you know there's this in the kitchen? I'm like, why would you do that?
Well, that's also, there's a deeper context to that story of this person who has a very, very warped sense of what she looks like to the point that she is probably... And this isn't shady. This is pretty factual. It's going to come across as shady, but she's probably, what, twice your size? Mm-hmm. And she thinks that you two are the same size.
Mm-hmm.
So that there's an explanation there of that whole saboteur thing.
Yeah.
The people I work with, they're not trying to sabotage me. They're just like, when are you going to be off this crazy thing? We want to have a potluck brunch, and we want you to be able to participate.
Well, do you have any futuristic would you like to set a goal that you can report back on our next podcast?
Oh, next podcast.
Yes.
Well, I would like to be back to Whole30 again. Okay. 99% of the time.
Okay.
My goal though is I want to do Whole30 starting June 1st to the end of the year, and I want that to be my benchmark of the change in my body. How do I feel? The biggest thing is how do I feel. So that's what I would like to do, and I don't want to necessarily be so strict that it's 100% Whole30 all the time. Like I said, even if it's 99.5% Whole30, I would be fine with that.
Yeah.
But,
okay, so, this is kind of funny. Do you remember before we started Whole30 and we had said, okay, at the end of Whole30, what's your, not reward, but I can't remember what word we had used. Do you remember that?
Mm.
And,
oh yeah.
Yours, I think, was going to get your hair done.
Mm-hmm.
And mine was going to be a bikini on the beach in Santa Monica and go in the water. Yeah, that didn't happen.
That didn't happen. It was also too cold.
Well, yeah, it was too cold, but already. So we went to Santa Monica 4 days in. So that would have been 6 days after Whole30 finished, right?
Yeah.
And I felt awful.
Yeah.
I felt so gross.
Well, you were also carrying a 90-pound bag of candy. Anyway.
And then had a hot dog and french fries on the beer.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that was the same day.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was a bad day. Now that I look at it that way, like, oh, no wonder I was sick.
I would like to I would like to do a combination maybe of, and I don't know how this would work, if it would work, but the whole, the program that I was talking about before, the Jackie eating that I liked.
Yeah.
And Whole30. And or, like a combination of the two, and do that till the end of the year and see how I feel.
Yeah.
Because at least maybe if, like maybe for me, if I'm allowed to have whipping cream, as an example, maybe that would help me get through the whipping cream or whipped cream? What's the difference?
Whipping cream is the actual liquid. Whipped cream is the liquid that becomes...
Okay, I want the whipped cream. You know, like... maybe if I allowed myself to have that on fruit, say, not all the time, but occasionally, that would satisfy that feeling of, I'm without, I need something sweet, I'm gonna die. That kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think what I'm gonna do this weekend is I am going to make an attempt to start a bullet journal.
Ooh.
And I am going to do a section that is going to be detailed food.
Ooh.
And I also need to start working out properly because I was, for the past 3 months, okay, before that, I was really good. I would work out 6 days a week and I would do like a reasonable workout. And then I stopped and I was doing, continued with arm weights, which take me all of 7 minutes in the morning. And then 10-minute yoga. So then the other day, I went back to one of my other workouts that I hadn't done since, you know, a long time ago. I'm so sore. For 2 days, I can barely walk. So I need to get back into some sort of, you know, proper moving my body routine.
Yeah.
And the scary part, the other thing that I was going to say before, the scary part for me too is I go to the doctor on Monday for the, it's not annual physical anymore, it's every second year.
That'd be biannual, it's either twice a year or once every 2 years.
Yeah, oh yeah, so once every 2 years I have to go and I am petrified to step on the scale. Petrified because, like, the last time I was on that scale, I was at a number where they would say, oh, you're such a tiny little thing. They're not going to say that this time.
That's vanity talking, though.
Yeah,
That's ego talking.
But so, is there anything wrong with that?
Well.
Like, is there? It's like I said to you earlier. There was a girl that walked by, and she was skinny, skinny, skinny. And bitch number two said, skinny twat. And bitch number two used to say that to me. And that's what I said to you. You don't say that to me anymore. And then I also had said, you used to say, your skin looks really good today, you bitch. And you don't say that to me anymore. And your response to me was,
it's your diet.
Yeah. Yeah. So.
Sorry.
No, I mean, that's good. It's good to hear stuff like that. So I guess we both set a target.
Mm-hmm.
And the next podcast, we will report back.
Also, well, I might be dead tomorrow because I signed up to do a 10K months ago, and have I run?
Nope.
So that'll be good luck.
Well, it's interesting because when you signed up for that, that's when you were doing your 30-day.
It was before that. But yeah.
And then you did the 30-day. What was the 30-day?
I did 30 days. Well, not 30 days. I did 30 classes in 30 days of yoga, bar, and row. So there were some days that I did. There were a couple days in the month of March that I did 3 classes in a row.
Yeah.
I'm gonna die.
You need to dig deep and find out where you got that drive.
Well, it was because A, I was going with people, and B, there was 2 months for free at the end of it. That,
how much of that have you used?
One class.
We still have
a month
left, so make the most of it. Okay, or not. On that note, bitch number two, do you have anything else to add?
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
And until next time, we will sign off from the banks of the Elbow River. And Bentley is panting up a storm, so need to go and get him some